Hi, I'm Debra Olin. I'm a visual artist and the gallery coordinator of Brickbottom Gallery, and I'm here to welcome you to the gallery and announce an exhibition that's going to open December called Somerville as Muse. A couple of years ago, I was awarded a community curator grant from the Somerville Museum to put together a show, a retrospective of David Campbell's paintings and drawings called The Art of Observation. So while I was setting up that exhibition, I started to notice other artists that use Somerville as their inspiration. And I thought, wouldn't it be great if I could put up a companion exhibition somewhere else in the city that would highlight these other artists as well? And so that's where Somerville as Muse came from. I want to say that although David Campbell was the perfect artist to represent the art of observation, he wasn't the first artist that contributed to my interest in the subject. And I want to talk for a minute about this painting. This is by an artist, David Scholl. David Scholl passed away in 2011, and he was an original founding member of the Brickbottom Artists Building, along with David Campbell and myself. This is a painting, a watercolor that he did of the radiator yard in Union Square. And I would walk by this radiator yard all the time, and I noticed it, but it didn't have much of an effect. And David Scholl, he studied this radiator yard, and he sketched it, and he painted numerous paintings of the scene and scenes like it. And David taught me that it was important to pay attention to your surroundings, and that through an artist's eyes, the everyday landscape was elevated, and that it was important to pay attention. So let me introduce the 12 artists that are in Somerville as Muse. Seth Berkowitz uses line and color and a quirky perspective to bring life and energy to the squares and gathering places of Somerville with watercolor and pen and ink. David Campbell, who I mentioned earlier, David is a plein air painter, and this painting is called The Street. Maybe you've seen it. It's been hanging in front of the mayor's door and Somerville City Hall for the last 20 years. Gary Dewar did a series of saints, lawn saints of Somerville. And again, it was one of those things that I never really noticed until they were recorded by Gary's photographs. Pierre Gustafson is just delighted by the Green Line Extension project, the moving of the earth and the machinery and the dirt and the noise. And he builds these constructions out of recycled cardboard. And they have a toy-like quality that I think puts a smile on everyone's face. Steve Imrich uses aerial views to paint his paintings with a color and a geometry that gives them an almost abstract quality. Kara Foster Kareem uses strips of newspaper to build up her cityscapes and storefront images through collage. And Mary Kokel must just have the camera strapped around her neck at all times, because she just seems to always be able to capture the magic of the moment that you could not ever plan. This is a painting by Adam LeVay, and it's called Empire Tattoo. It's on the corner of Washington Street and McGrath Highway. And this painting is of a building that you would never recognize today. It's had a major facelift. And this is one of the things I love about this project, is that it talks about the past, it talks about the present, and then I have a future artist who is Mark Luigi. And Mark Luigi did this very fanciful illustration of the new Gilman Station, Green Line Extension Station, that is his idea of how it could look with the lion mascot that was in the building that was torn down to put this up in its place. Simmer Rees has a window view from her studio that has been changing over the years from the trees that obstructed her view from the beginning, 34 years ago, to the community path that's obstructing her view now. Rachel Mello uses paint and shadow and light and cutout images to bring a dreamlike quality to and a sense of memory to her work. Ron Pownell had the opportunity to record the demolition of the waste management trash transfer station that's in the Brickbottom neighborhood, and this is going to be the home someday of the future art farm. So now the artists are all going to speak a little bit about their process and their work and the influence that Somerville has had on them. And I hope that you come back in December to see the exhibition when it's at the Brickbottom Gallery. Thank you.